Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue Eden Streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for the support on the Eden Streak and the Like Streak. It is absolutely bonkers. You guys and gals are hitting 1K likes before even 5 hours are going by now. Unbelievable. CJ is going to be 4 Tango November 4, BAF 6. We've got just terrible damage. Like, just, ugh. Okay, tears rate. Kind of okay movement speed, not really that great, but 2.85 movement speed is a, or 2.85 damage, I should say, is a, it's almost an insult at this point. We also have Spirit of the Night, which is the reason, only reason why I went to the curse room, because it's only going to cost us half of a soul heart to actually get in and get out. We had a chance to get something else in there, so it would have been nice. We also have the Louse, which is going to do something. Chance to spawn a spider while in a hostile room. There you go. I had something to do with poop piles, but I could be mistaken on that. I mean, it obviously was, because it's not what it does at all. Mr. Mega, of course, always a great addition to the team. We're lucky to have you, Mr. Mega. Mr. Mega is going to increase the blast radius and the damage of the bombs that we place down. I don't actually know if it enhances the damage or not, but it does make the blast radius larger, which makes bombs more effective and awesome and looks really cool. And Mr. Mega is always a good idea. Also gives you 5 bombs upon acquisition, which is very neat. I left a little bit too early before that shot hit that fire, so we're going to go back and put that out. Also going to try to go for a bomb here for the Keeper. Get one. Now, the Keeper heads that have nickels in them, they tend to have a nickel drop out of them. Not always, though. And once you know it, we get more options. Now, more options is a fantastic item to start with. Well, right now, I don't want to bomb the donation machine if there's a chance that we can actually get money without having to do that. And we also don't have to waste a bomb, if possible. If possible. It's a very weird first floor here. It looks like some sort of weird FTL ship. Not sure if I'm okay with that. I'm going to drop a bomb here just because I want to take down the champion. Also because the Super Seeking Room had a chance to be right there. I actually thought I was going to be to the left of here. And by the way, if I happen to be speaking a little bit off today, like my pronunciation and verbiage, it's not a word, it's because I actually have a cut underneath my tongue, which hurts really badly. That's one of those like slices, you know? Don't ask me how I did it. I have no idea. I woke up and I was like, wow, my tongue really hurts. Oh, what were you doing, Jadikta? I was clearly making out with a tarantula. I don't know why that would cut my tongue. I don't even want to think about that. Either way, I woke up and I was like, man, my tongue is actually like hurting a lot. And I looked at it in the mirror and like the bottom of my tongue is like cut. I don't know how that happened. So, and of course, like everything feels like it's 13 billion times the size than it actually is whenever you have like a wound or something going on in your mouth. Like if you ever, like for those of you who've ever chipped a tooth, you know exactly what I'm talking about. If you even have like the smallest little crack or chip inside of a tooth, it feels like it's spanning the Grand Canyon. I am actually offended that we even got hit there. I was going to use the Book of Belial, but now we're just going to bomb Dingle to death. So more options is going to give us a double item room from here on out, which again is very good. This is the best time, the absolute perfect time for us to get more options because we're at the very beginning of a run. Much like Gertie Jr., one thing you do not want to do is get horizontal with Dingle or diagonal. You always, pretty much all you want to do is just straight. It doesn't even matter what direction you're moving. Just stay straight whenever Dingle or Gertie Jr. or even Gurglings are coming straight at you. The worst thing you can do is try to shoot them while they are charging you, and that's going to cause them to take the Isaac's physics, which we all know and love, and just go bonkers. So we end up getting the Binky, which is going to go say tears up. Which is very good. We need to be careful, of course, about our HP because we did not get a red heart deal. Well, not a deal, but we just didn't get a red heart drop from the boss. That's why Poop's going to be an excellent addition here to the early game. That's why Poop's going to give us a chance to get a good amount of consumables out of poop piles, including eternal hearts, soul hearts, that kind of stuff. Obviously, top tier is going to be the Cards Against Humanity card. That's what we're going to be looking for right now. The perfect complement to the petrified poop. Down they go. Okay. So we've got one key, one bomb, 1 cent. I didn't even talk about Spirit of the Night. Spirit of the Night, by the way, is what we have. And it will give us flying, obviously. That's the reason why I went to the Curse Room, blah, blah, blah. I already talked about that. But another nice thing about Spirit of the Night is the fact that it does have spectral tiers. What that means is that we don't have to worry, as you can plainly see, about any environmental hazards or any obstructions, which is great. So now some people sometimes get this confused with piercing shots. They see the shots traveling through like rocks and through pots and mushrooms and stuff. They're like, oh, we got piercing. No, it's not exactly piercing. I guess it's environmental piercing if you want to think of it that way. But just, I mean, they're spectral tears. That's all they are. They are not obstructed by anything other than something physically getting in their way that is not related to the level. So again, rocks, pots, mushrooms, skulls, all that kind of stuff. The spectral tears just goes right through them. But it's not piercing shots, just so we're clear. Definitely could use like some damage, any damage. Our biggest, this would be our biggest want and need right now. We definitely want to get more damage. Magic Mush would be amazing. A need would just be red hearts for now. Preferably red hearts that give you damage, like meat. Meat would be a pretty good one to get. I am going to open up this stone chest here. Might have a chance to get the secret door, but it's going to be iffy. Yeah. I am going to take Head of the Keeper, even though I don't like it. It will at least give us a little bit of extra value, especially in the early game where we're going to need money because this run is bad enough, at least to start anyway, to be quite dangerous. Hit a rock. It would have worked out had we gotten another bomb. We still have a chance to go buy another bomb, I suppose, or we could just get one. That's fine, too. Thank you, game. Okay, we still can't take a devil deal, but we're getting there. Box of spiders or halitosis. I'll begrudgingly take halitosis because there's no reason for us to stick with something that, I mean, that we need the Book of Belial, flat out. Even when the Book of Belial got nerfed, for those of you who don't know, Book of Belial used to give you an almost guaranteed deal with the devil chance when you use it. It used to bump that up to, I believe, 75% if it wasn't 100 or higher. So Book of Belial was top tier for a very, very, very long time. It's not exactly not top tier anymore. It's still very good because it just gives you more damage. But certainly it lost a lot of its luster whenever it got nerfed, and it no longer affects your devil deal chances at all. Now, obviously, we have 100% chance right now just because we're on floor 2. And we're just at the start of a run, obviously. So we do get damage and tiers, or damage and range. And we can't take any of these in here unless we get a miracle and get like a strength card or a soul heart or something. Nope. 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 Hopefully the devil deal is still open when we get back in there. The only thing that we can take here is a soul heart and hope that the devil deal is still open, because I would love to get Rotten Baby. It's still open. Okay. Thank you, Stanley. Rotten Baby is going to be huge for us. So Rotten Baby is going to be a familiar that shoots out a fly, an attack fly. Now, what's nice about Rotten Baby is that there is no limit to the flies that he can shoot. However, he can only have one at a time, one active fly. So in other words, the fly that he summons has to be consumed before he will summon another one. Consumed, by consumed, I mean just not present, as in he's not like around. Dim Bulb, we've been seeing Dead Bulb like a lot lately. Dim Bulb is okay when you have a one charge item and don't have the 9-volt, which we have neither, so I'm not gonna take it. Petrified Poop is still very important, obviously, just because it does give us a... I'll take Dim Bulb since we don't have a charge right now. But yeah, Petrified Poop just gives us a little bit more value. And all stats up, yes, that would be amazing. But with the spacebar item that we are going to use, Dim Bulb would certainly warrant a little bit of a consideration. However, I still think I'd rather have the ability to get passive rewards from stuff that normally we wouldn't get much, if any, reward out of. Having an all stats up, of course, it is important. Let's not overlook that. It is important, but the requirements of Dim Bulb working are kind of demanding. They're easy. Dim Bulb works as long as you have no charge. It has to be zero charge on your spacebar item, which pretty much means that you just have to have a one charge item. I mean, you can have it for like, you know, a very large charge item, but you essentially have to make sure that you use that item at the same time. Ooh, man. This is hard. I think we go with a D-Wizzle. The D-Wizzle. So the D1 is a good item. What it does, it's a thinking man's item. I will say this. It is a thinking man's item. The cracked eye. So this is what it does. It will duplicate something on the ground. I don't think it will duplicate trinkets. I'm not going to risk it right now. I'm going to go for the duplication on the bomb here. Now, you might think that that's crazy. You're saying, what are you talking about, Sinvicta? Why would you duplicate the bomb? You got a soul heart right there. Because this is a bedroom. And because this is a bedroom, as you remember from an earlier episode this week, if you have no red hearts, you get 3 soul hearts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a targeted duplication with the D1. It sounds overly verbose and overly complicated. It really isn't. Just take whatever you don't want to be duplicated off of the ground. The more that you eliminate off the ground, the higher the chances that you get to duplicate what you want. In theory, in perfect situations like this, we can actually take everything off the ground that we don't want to be duplicated and do what I call a targeted duplication on the one thing that's still alive, that's still there. So we're guaranteed to get another bomb here. All right. So we already have the soul heart. Which, yes, if we duplicated that, sure, that would have been awesome. But what's even better is going into a bedroom here with flying. This would have been a real annoying situation. Run into the bed. We get 3 soul hearts anyway. So that would have been a good example of a play that I would have just done and then not explained. So that's why I'm trying to give these overly elaborate explanations as to try to help out newer players. Of what the thought process is there. So yes, duplicating the soul heart would have been nice, but you know what's even better than 1 soul heart? Getting 4 soul hearts. 1 from the floor and 3 from the bed, sort of thing, you know. Which is the name of my newest romantic novel, by the way. Probably shouldn't read too much into that. In fact, you probably shouldn't read it at all. Just don't even listen to me. Halitosis, by the way, it does give us that poison, and no, it does not, unfortunately, give you any sort of black heart generation like some other poison effects do, like Serpent's Kiss or the virus. That would have been nice, but didn't happen. All right, so I'm going to do a targeted duplication on the key because we need some Yaves. But the D1 is awesome. It is very underrated, in my opinion. I think most of it has to do with people just overthink how to use it, or they don't know how to properly use it. So, you know, this might be our love song to the D1. Now, what's even more awesome about the D1, it's like a Yara rune that you can control. So we now find ourselves in the situation where we can start taking stuff from the store. And let's think about this. Do we want HP? Will we want to duplicate HP? We have a 1 in 4 shot of duplicating the soul heart. We say, well, yes, we want more HP, so let's see what this card is first before we start thinking about HP. 2 of clubs. 2 of clubs is going to double our bombs. Would we want to double that? Possibly, but I think we should hold off of that for now. So now we have a 1 in 3 shot at getting our soul heart. I say 1 in 3 because, remember, we can also get this key here. I think it's better for us to try for the soul heart and then also get the battery here. So I would like to get the battery. What I'm going to do is I'm just simply going to buy it, and then once we get a full charge, we'll be able to go back there and hopefully get a soul heart. Now, you might be thinking, oh yeah, what a big galaxy brain play there. First off, great speech there, and secondly, yeah, it's not over yet, because there's an additional layer to this strategy, which I'll show you in a moment. Again, this is not complicated. It is not complicated at all, but if you know how to exploit and use all this stuff to your advantage, the D1 can be extremely powerful, especially when you're starting to talk about full charges on the ground. Now, again, talk about full charges. This is targeted duplication. We say, okay, we can get a duplicate here. We don't have any more. Unfortunately, we don't have any more rooms to go through, so we can only get 2 full charges, and then that's it. So we're not going to worry about this, but One thing we can do is we can go back here and we can increase our odds of getting this soul heart and even more soul hearts out of this. So what we're going to do is we're going to hope that it hits the soul heart here. I'm going to even stand close to it just for good luck. Okay. Now that we've done that, we say, okay, we got our soul heart, but why are you not picking it up? Well, because we have another charge on the D1, and since we've actually increased the odds of us getting the soul heart to be duplicated, now we have a 66% chance of getting it. It went up from 50 to 66. Now, we have the possibility of turning one soul heart into three soul hearts for the price of one. And there we go. Beautiful. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Taking slow, methodical thought processes and turning them into strategy is part of that's a layer of Isaac that not a lot of newer players will be able to appreciate. Now, again, I'm not trying to make myself out to be look like a genius. Yeah, obviously the more copies of a particular item that we want that we leave on the ground is going to greatly increase our chances of getting said item. Yes. That's fundamental mathematics right there. But just thinking like that can really give you the leg up that you really, that sometimes you desperately want or need in this game. And that's what's so great about Isaac. It can be as serious or as casual as you want it to be. So now, what are we looking for? We're looking for a full charge. Why? Because if we get a full charge that we can duplicate that's on the ground, we can effectively duplicate something on the ground as many times as we want, effectively, having a Yara rune. And that's awesome. Being able to duplicate stuff just whenever you want to is super duper good in this game, as you all are well aware of. And because the D1 gives you that ability, it makes it a very, very powerful item. Did we not go into that item room? The last floor? No, we did. That's where we got the D1. Right? I don't know. I don't remember. I think we did. Yeah, because it was the D1 versus Little Brimstone. That's right. All right, full charge, loaded up, ready to go. Now all we're looking for is an actual full charge. Now, you might be asking yourself, Invicta, What about chests? Could you use the D1 on chests the way that you use Yara runes? The answer is yes, you can. Now, I'm going to be greedy here. I'm not going to leave the soul heart, but what I am going to do is I want more bombs. So how do we get more bombs out of this? Well, very simply, we just duplicate the two of clubs. Look at that. More bombs. There's no reason for us to duplicate it right now. There's no reason. I didn't mean to pick up that nickel. Holding tab kind of screwed it up there. Anyway, but yeah, there's no reason for us to duplicate the two of clubs again. There's no reason for us to consume it yet. So, now let's talk about chests. Do chests work the way that they work with a Yara rune? Like, if we duplicate a chest that has an item in it, will it produce another item? Yes. The answer is yes, it will. I'm not going to worry about the barrels here just because we have enough bombs. So, I'm just trying to blow through some of this fire here. Okay, I'll leave this one barrel just for S's and G's. Now, I'm not going to blow up these two chests right now because I want to see if one of them has an item in it. So that room, the super secret room, is going to be our main focus for duplication for now, unless if we find a full charge. Ideally, we would find a full charge in this room so we don't have a very long walk back over to the super secret room. Probably won't work out like that, but it would be nice, you know. Be nice. Keep in mind, we don't have a good start here. This is not good. We don't have good stats, we don't have anything, but we are making things work because we know how to exploit what the game gives us. And what it's given us right now is a golden opportunity to really bust this run wide open. Which is why one of the most important things I tell newer Isaac players is that They always ask me, Simvicta, what's the best tips you can give me for as a new player? As a new player, learn the items and learn how to dodge. You can't win a run if you don't know how to dodge. You can't win a run if you don't know what the items do. I'm not saying you have to memorize them. In fact, I would discourage from trying to memorize them because it's going to take up valuable brain space for, you know, enemy knowledge and boss patterns. that sort of thing. So Doyle is going to give us damage. That's what I want. We get Eye of Belial and the Goat Head. So we're going to take both of these here. Eye of Belial, of course, is going to give us Possessed Tears, which are going to be piercing, and they also are homing whenever they go through a target. They deal double damage, and it's very, very good. Shiny Rock is a decent trinket, but not one that I need or want. So let's go talk about the chests again. Why are we waiting for a full charge? Hopefully we get one on the ground soon-ish. So we have one to duplicate.
How come you won't duplicate in those chests, Victor?
Well, chances are that we were not going to duplicate anything that had an item in there. And on top of that, I really don't want to go back and forth inside of a cursed room that doesn't have a full charge on the ground, as that would cost us basically the run and the streak. The suicide mission, I tell you. So the only thing you have to remember about piercing shots, like Eye of Belial, like Sagittarius, like Cupid's Arrow, and other of the sorts, is that make sure you don't try to shoot or try to knock back bombs that are encroaching upon your position, because it won't work. The piercing shots would just go right through them. So that is one thing to keep in mind. Okay, which chest do we duplicate? We duplicated this one. So I'm going to separate these two just so I know which of the chests actually this came out of. So now we're going to drop a bomb and say, are we going to get an item out of here? And we do. So guaranteed this item or this chest here will produce items as long as we duplicate that. That's step number one. We have now found a source of items that we can duplicate at will. Now, the second part of this puzzle is finding a full charge. We need to find a full charge on the ground before we run out of rooms on this floor. If we can do that, it's over. And look at that. Speak and ye shall receive.
Two of clubs.
I'm just using the two of clubs because we don't need it anymore. Temperance machine, we don't need anymore. Okay. So phase two. We have a full charge on the ground. Oh my goodness, we have another one. Which one's closer? Probably the one over there. This room. And we don't even have to worry. We don't even have to worry about there being another full charge because we can just take this one. But we're still going to do, we're going to do what I was going to do, which is just, now that we have two on the ground, all you need now to break the game, to infinitely break the game, is get one more full charge out of your spacebar item, by any means necessary, but we already have it, so. Yeah, you know what, why not? Didn't you take these chests, Invicta? What was that, Timmy? Didn't you duplicate these chests, Invicta? Yeah, you could. But why? We don't know if any of these chests have items in it. We know that there is one chest that has an item in it, and it's a guppy item. So well, there's no point in trying to duplicate these, especially since these cost keys. You know what I mean? We can open up that other chest by just bombs, and we've got plenty of that. So those of you who've been waiting for a game-breaking run, here you go. And it comes at a very good time, too, because this run's going downhill fast as far as our stats are concerned. And, we still just... I'm not trying to do a full clear. I'm just looking for the item room and the store. That's all I'm looking for. The patron saint of Dead End strikes again. How does he do it? How does he do it? I don't know.
You're wasting a full charge, Victor.
First off, we're not. Secondly, we don't need a full charge. We already have our battery room. It's a literal battery for our battery room. Not even going to dignify either of these items with a response. Secret room might be here. Yep. No real arrow in this one. This one is just a... It's a recognizable room for me. We can save a key here, but I'm lazy. Okie dokie. We're just going to buy this and get on out. Let's get out. You know what? Let's put some money back. We're done needing the store. We don't need anything else from the store. I mean, if we get more stuff from the store, that'd be awesome, but it's not something we need. Look at that. We're back over 700 cents. The Sinvicta's donation machine is probably very happy. You're welcome. All right, let's get down to brass tacks and business. Let's get down to business. B-I-D-N-E-S-S. Well, you forgot that we had the battery. And also, there's one crucial mistake about this whole game-breaking thing. It doesn't actually double everything on the ground. It simply duplicates one thing. So it takes one full charge to duplicate a full charge. I was thinking of it in Yara term. So we cannot infinitely break this item run yet. There's one part that I'm neglecting to remember is the fact we need car battery for that. Okay, so this red heart's bad. That's why is it bad? Because we have a chance of this actually duplicating instead of this chest. Yeah. And now with every duplication over there, it's going to greatly increase the chance that we're going to duplicate that. This is basically the reverse logic of what we did on the first floor or second floor, whatever. Third floor, it doesn't matter. So yeah, so what happened there is me having the battery was making me think that I actually had the car battery, which is not true at all. Yes, I am still tired. Even though I did get sleep last night. Let's hope that this duplicates the chest at least once. Okay. We still get two items. It's not ideal. The only thing that could have screwed us would have been a red heart, and that's exactly what happened. Because it's the only currency that we cannot do anything with. But it is what it is. But had we had the car battery doing exactly what I was doing, we would have been able to infinitely break the game. Unless if a red heart showed up. There's always a chance, but yeah. So that's the game getting a little salty at us. Or it won't give us any item, excuse me. I'm very confused by it. The only thing that makes sense is the fact that maybe we duplicated the item and that because it had to respawn the other item, it turned it into an item. I don't know. Whatever. Curse the blind, hooray. I don't know what to say about that last floor. Everything that I did there, despite us not having the battery, or the car battery, we have the battery. Everything should have been correct there with the D1. I don't know why a chest that we duplicated, which produced an item, didn't give us another item. The only thing I can think of is that because it was a guppy item, or it's an item that you can find in a global item pool. That it rolled it against that loot table instead of just having a guaranteed item? I don't know. Luckfoot's going to give us a luck upgrade. No idea what the other item is. Doesn't matter. It's Curse of Blind. So yeah, so that was a little bit of a misadventure. But all kidding and joking aside, if you do find yourself with the D1 and you get the car battery, then do what I just did on that last floor. Although I don't know why the chest did not produce another item. It should have. So there's a variable that I'm not privy to, or at least one that I'm not remembering. And by the way, we're sticking with Guppy's head because we need damage. Had that produced a bunch of items, then we would have been fine. But now we're moving on. We're moving away from the Zane and going into the. We need to win. We actually need to win this run. Curse the Blind really screws us up here. Again, with it being Curse of the Blind, I'm not going to worry about going to the store because, I mean, we don't have... We sort of have unlimited money, I suppose, but it's still not worth your money to go... It's not worth your money to go and buy stuff in the store that you can't see. It's better to wait. And Ninetales gives us damage and shot speed up, and we get a non-devil deal devil deal. All right. Let's hope for us to not get a greed fight here. But I mean, we need stuff. Damage is in an okay spot right now, especially after getting Cat of Nine Tails. Our DPS is quite good. Thanks to the flies and Cat of Nine Tails. Damon's Tail, we might as well have them at this point. Petrified Poop didn't really do much for us, although I don't think Petrified Poop got a rare or a fair shake either. All right, store time. Hopefully it's not a greed fight. Actually, it's not a store. It's a dice room. No, it's a vault. Yesterday's run was intense. I wasn't feeling nervous yesterday, but I was feeling, I don't know. Was I concerned about the streak ending? Yeah, of course. I'm concerned about the streak ending on all runs. Yesterday's run certainly was testing. And to be honest, if the streak was going to end, it would have been in a situation like yesterday's, where the only advantage that I had or that I needed to reclaim would have been Polar Invincibility, and I squandered that by accidentally picking up that or not accidentally, but I didn't mean to pick up that that half heart in that last room and let Darkbum do it. The fact that I had Darkbum on that run clouded my vision and my judgment from seeing the fact that I needed to stop him from taking that half heart so we could have Polar Invincibility. But at the end of the day, we beast moded it. This is a game that I am not afraid of. Not afraid of any game, really. Super Secret Room is almost always guaranteed to be north of here. Almost always. You see this room? All right, we're just looking for that item room and store now. We can, once again, the patron saint of dead ends. I'm losing my voice. Risk of Rain has been killing it. Killing my voice and killing the numbers. And thank you, everyone, for those of you who may have subbed from the Risk of Rain series. My main game is The Binding of Isaac. It's a game that I played for many years now. And vice versa, if you've not watched Risk of Rain 2 yet, highly recommend it. And one of the first videos you should watch is the co-op video, because you can see how much fun you can have with your friends. Me and Coach Krendor, even though we're not the greatest video game players out there, we still had fun. We did a couple of really quality runs. I am going to be uploading a little bit more of those VODs, because I'm going to take a little bit of a break from doing Isaac and Risk of Rain 2 back to back like I was, because it really is killing my throat. By the way, another dead end with no rooms of note. Yep. How does he do it? I mean, like, just look at this map. I want you to stop and look at this map and tell me who was the Isaac player who played it. And try to explain to somebody how, despite all mathematical odds, someone can go through this map and not find a particular room. The maps that spawn the shop and the item room adjacent from each other that's the troll map. And we've got another one here. But even if it wasn't a troll map, like, I still would have done this just because I just don't know where I'm going all the time. Somehow, some way, we just do it. Begrudgingly take Zodiac. It's not a great item, but it can help. Got Scorpio. Okay. Thank you for the reroll machine game. Zodiac, by the way, is going to give us a chance for a random Zodiac effect. So, like, Yeah, we can take pH Dizzle. Why not? Power Pill, okay. Telepills. It's a half-price stopwatch. I'll take it.
Two
hearts.
Hearts.
Not really necessary. Chaos. I will take Chaos. Treasure map would also be nice if we can get... If we can get 9 more cents, man, but I don't know. It's gonna be a tall order considering that we've already done the entire freaking floor. Mom's lipstick for some reason. I don't think I've ever seen that drop out of a vanity mirror. Only reason why I'm doing this room is because we have Head of the Keeper, so I'm hoping that we spawn like a nickel or a dime or something more than 2 cents would be nice. Okay, so we need 5 cents. Now, there is a chance for us to get that 5 cents. It's going to be a little bit of a gamble because we're going to need to use the telepills for it, but we can get this 5 cents to get the treasure map. Why do you want the treasure map, Invicta? Well, Timmy, it's because you've seen what happened on this floor. Right? Like, you've been watching this. I know you have. The telepills. So where am I going? So the objective for us is this. I'm gonna try to make 5 cents appear by fighting Mom and then possibly fighting Krampus inside the devil deal. We know we're gonna get a devil deal because we have the goat head. You might be wondering, well, where's the gamble at? Well, the gamble is the fact that telepills has a chance to take you to the I Am Error room, which is not what you want. We get small rocks. Small rocks a big pickup for us here. The movement speed down is negligible. Just need 2 more cents. 2 more cents, Mom. 1 more cent, and we can get the treasure map as long as we don't get teleported to the I Am Error room. There we go. Okie dokie. Polaroid, and it's a Krampus fight to be expected. Lump of coal would be very nice with Eye of Belial. Doing this to see if we can get another black card would be nice. Magician card. Alright, let's test our luck. Good. Good. So that worked out great. So even though this is a pretty long run, it worked out okay. You can buy this tarot card. Why not? You know, the power pill card would actually be better. The telepill's pill might be better than that. But dude, why do you keep going in here? That's not connected, brain. This is like one of the oddest maps I think I've ever seen in this game. There's so many false hallways that make you think you're gonna go to the boss. I mean, look at it. Like it really does look like Sinvicta bait here.
Bet you thought the boss is this way, loser. Wrong, nerd.
This is a very weird. I have a feeling the boss is going to be all the way to the east. I'm basing that just off of pure guesswork. And you're seeing the value here of the fear shot there. You see the value of Spectral Tears and Eye of Belial. We can just sit back and let the rocks do the blocking for us. Oh. Not where the boss is.
Strike one, nerd. Loser.
All right. Let's go see what this is over here. I don't care about money anymore. I might as well dip up into this room just to see if it's adjacent. It's not. I dropped that bomb there because I was expecting mom hands. I'm just being lazy. I didn't want to feel like messing with it. But yeah, we can beat that floor or beat that room. Now, are we gonna play this demon judgment? I'm gonna say no because we don't have a great way to make up our money yet. By money, I mean our HP. We have chaos, of course, which is gonna shuffle all the loot tables, which means that we don't need as much HP as we normally would, but I would still rather not have to worry about HP, especially after what happened yesterday. Ooh, man. White Pony and the battery and 9 volts, real good. Now, it's good, but we don't need it. We don't need it because we have flying. Oh, Curse the Blind. We have flying, and we have a spacebar item that, while it's not as good as White Pony with Crack the Sky, it's still adequate for what we need it for. Oh, wow. Okay, well, I mean, now we could have played that Demon Judgment. Guilt-free, but oh well. Okay. I actually meant to stop moving there, but we got vortexed into that. The left hand, by the way, is that trinket that we have. And if you're wondering why we're getting a bunch of cursed chests showing up, it's because of the left hand. Turns all chest drops into red chest drops. That's very significant for two reasons. One, because it has a pretty good high tendency to pay out with soul hearts out of red chests. And B, because you can actually get devil deals and even guppy items out of it. But since we have chaos, that doesn't really matter anymore. But I still have the red chest just in case we can get teleported to deal with the devil. Would be kind of nice.
You have goat head, Invicta.
Yeah, I know I have goat head, but still, it's nice to just to know that, oh, I can just leave the floor after the boss instead of having to decide, you know? Or if you have something that's very good in the devil deal, you get to utilize it now instead of having to wait until after you're done killing the boss. You can use what's inside the devil deal against the boss that you're currently fighting. Isn't that neat? All right, Curse the Blind. How bold are we going to get? Answers vary. Bob's Curse. Tammy's Head. Tammy's Head is good, but not as good as Guppy's Head in this spot. There's a darkness again. The treasure map is invaluable in this situation. Situation where we don't necessarily have an OP run, and we have no way of recovering our HP by means of like Book Revelations, Satanic Bible, etc. Okay. Let's stop the shenanigans here. I cannot tell you how irritating it is for the ghost to spawn right on top of you as you're moving away from one another one. We have blue fires here. Let's take advantage of these. Hopefully get one soul heart out of it. Would be nice. There's usually a tinted rock in here. This time there happens to be not. Not even a double tinted rock. This room, get out of it as fast as possible. If you can, get out of this room as fast as possible. Daddy Longlegs, an RNG troll and a half of a boss. You can't really manipulate where Daddy is going to throw down his feet. Take it nice and slow. By the way, that slowing effect is created by the fact that we took damage while we had the stopwatch. The blue stopwatch, not the broken one, but the regular one, the one that you see at the bottom right-hand side of your screen. That one will activate whenever Isaac takes damage. Everything gets slowed down by a whole lot. It's a very good defensive item. Some people even say it was overpowered. I think the old version of it was definitely overpowered. The old version of the stopwatch, the working one, it used to give the entire floor the spider bite effect or the slowing effect, and it would do it immediately and passively. So it made for really easy, boring runs. Now, drop a left hand, Invicta. I know. I'm dropping left hand. That's the reason why I use the priestess card right there, is because I want the telepills so we can telepills in the chest to hopefully get taken right to Blue Baby. We're not in a safe spot. This run is not won yet. Especially if telepills doesn't help us out. This is a very linear level. I wonder where Blue Baby is. What are we looking for here? Honestly, anything. I would take Red Heart HP here. I would. Roid Rage. I believe that is 2 or 3 for Spun. 9 lives randomly. That pretty much seals the deal. Sad Bombs and Fairy Bombs, Glitter Bombs. Again, proving my theory that whenever you take Chaos, the first items that you find are going to be bomb items. I don't know why. It's something that I've confirmed and speculated ever since Chaos was introduced. Now, that was stupid damage. There's no reason for me to get that close to war. We have no orbitals. There's no reason for that. I don't even know why I did that, to be honest. We're getting tagged by a bunch of wayward damage here. I'm not worried though. I mean, 9 lives pretty much seals the deal here. It's unfortunate that telepills didn't take us further. But telepills technically did save us 4 rooms. And who knows what? There you go, another bomb item. Who knows what, you know, what bosses we had to skip there? So it was still a good play. Could have been better. Again, another bomb item. You know what? Let's have some fun.
Shoot, y'all know me.
It's like really weak gangster Bob Ross. I wish I had Bob Ross's voice. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to load up tons and tons of bombs. I don't recommend doing this, by the way, because we're just being silly right now. And we're taking a great amount of unnecessary risk here. But where's the fun in not taking risks? We're going to end today's run with a bang, with a nice sparkly bang here. The stopwatch actually makes this a lot easier, a lot safer, obviously. Which is the only reason why I would still be doing this. I would have already hit the fireworks, but since it's almost impossible for us to get another hit here. We got the chopped and screwed version of Blue Baby theme. Diablo 2. Another thing you won't be able to unhear after Invicta ruins it for you. Thank you. Okay. And let's put some outer edge explosions here. We're gonna have our safe corner over on the left side. On a count of 3, everyone. 1, 2. Actually, we should be counting down. 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year! Oh, Blue Baby one shot. There's the thumbnail. Not really. I better. If I made that the thumbnail, yell at me in the comments. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. Make sure if you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Subscribe. Thank you for those of you who are new subscribers here. We've already passed 72,000, almost 73,000. That's absolutely bonkers. Thank you all so much. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.